Thank you, Father, this morning. Thank you for your Son, Jesus. Thank you that we can proclaim the name of Jesus this morning, Lord. Lord, we don't want to function or speak out of any other place, not our own understanding, not our own thoughts, Lord, but we want to speak the name of Jesus into every situation, Lord. We speak the name of Jesus over ourselves and our families today, our friends, Lord. Lord, and we pray that you'll find in us an open heart this morning, Lord. Hearts that are surrendered unto you to receive from you this morning, Lord. Hearts that are vulnerable to come and receive from you, Lord, and to allow you to work in us today, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Volker, you're welcome up.
Thank you. Glory be to God. What a wonderful day to proclaim the name of Jesus. And that name of Jesus wants to bring healing to you. That name of Jesus wants to take away and blow away those clouds of discouragement that want to just be around us in these days. We want to declare the name of Jesus brings freedom. It brings hope and life to us. So last week, we were really blessed with a word from Gideon, and he said, man's extremity, when we don't know anymore what to do, it's God's opportunity. And I feel that this morning, there's something that's connected to this, because in Psalm 127, verse 1 and 2. We read about the psalmist who makes it so clear that unless the Lord builds the house, those who labor, labor in vain. Yes, we know what to do. We know how to build. We know how to do this. We know how to do that. But unless the Lord is the foundation of it, it's going to be in vain. And in the same way, unless those people who are on the walls of the city, when they look out for the enemy, unless the Lord is watching over the city, they watch in vain. That sounds really discouraging, but it's actually bringing us back to the very bottom, the very foundation, and that's Jesus Christ. He is the rock. He is not sinking sand. And in these days, we need to ask ourselves, am I really fully committed to the Lord Jesus Christ? And what excites me is that Jesus, hallelujah, He is not only the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, which sounds fantastic, but you know, He is such a King who died for me. He laid down His life for me. In these days, it's not time to look for self-promotion, to self-aggrandization. No, wisdom in these days gives us the ability to humble ourselves before our mighty God. That's what he's looking for in these days. You see, the watchmen, when they watch and they get discouraged, they want to give up. They want to throw in the towel. But you know, we are not those who throw in the towel. We are not giving up. We know that in these days, what we have to do is we have to fight the fight against discouragement, against losing hope, against just walking by our feelings, by the pain we experience, by the surroundings that want to discourage us. But we are to walk by faith and not by sight. That's what God is calling us to. So, it's not the time to look for quick solutions. It's amazing that, you know, when you go on the internet or wherever, you don't even have to worry about people send you messages left, right, and center. They give you all the good ideas. They know exactly how to solve the problem. But you know what? Our trust needs to be in the Lord. If we don't put our trust in the Lord, it shall all be in vain. It will all come to nothing. It will crumble. And so when you find you yourself get discouraged, watch out. You are just dropping your shield. Now is the time to pick up your shield again, to stand against the evil one. The other night, I had to just fight the good fight of faith. I had to tell the devil that he is defeated in my life. He has no power in my life. He is not going to interrupt me and discourage me and rob me of my joy that is mine in Christ Jesus. We have to take a stand for Jesus. And so Jesus wants to be a safe haven for every one of us in these days. He doesn't want us to feel lost. He doesn't want us to feel like orphans. He wants to encourage us. And it's amazing to me that, you know, here is Jesus. He is telling his disciples that he is going to leave them in John chapter 14, verse 1 to 3. In John, he's just trying to warn them and protect them from discouragement. And so he says, very clearly, it's not on the screen, but it says there that let not your heart be troubled. You see, let not your heart be troubled. That's what the Lord is saying to you and me today. He doesn't want us to be discouraged. He doesn't want us to just go down the tube like all the others. Let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God and believe also in me. What an encouraging word that is. But the disciples, they didn't grasp that. When you read it there in John chapter 14 yourself, they were still discouraged. They didn't know yet the good news. What was the good news? The good news was that he was telling them that he is going to prepare a place for them. Actually, what Jesus was saying, guys, I've got a home for you. I'm making a home for you. So don't be discouraged. Don't give up. Don't listen to what other people have to say. Listen to me, because I am giving you a home. And what's so good about a home is that at home you can experience acceptance. You can experience the love of God. It is true that God sometimes has to rebuke us. But you know, he will never, ever reject us. No, he is there for you and me today to affirm his love, his forgiveness, and his compassion. Jesus made it so clear that the Father and I are one. And the Father's ultimate desire is revealed in Revelation and in the second last chapter 21 and 3. And there it says, you see, what was Jesus' desire? To be with his disciples, to give them a home. And what is the Father's desire? Now, this is what's so exciting. In Revelation chapter 21, verse 3, there it says, a loud voice. I heard a loud voice. Hallelujah. That's an exciting, that should wake us up. Amen. And listen to what that voice has to say, because that's what's the exciting part. That reveals the Father's heart to us. I heard a loud voice from heaven. Behold, another word says, look, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. God himself will be with them and be their God. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There shall be no more death, nor sorrow, nor crying. There shall be no more pain, for the former things have passed away. Hallelujah. Isn't it exciting? Thank you. Glory be to God. That's the voice, a loud voice, with confidence that God is planning to spend eternity with you and me who believe in him. We have a home. Hallelujah. We no longer orphans. So don't listen to your feelings. Don't listen to the disappointments. Don't just attend funerals. But go. Go home. Go into the presence of God. And let him encourage you that you are his son. And he will never reject you. He will always affirm his love and kindness and forgiveness. So, the second verse in Psalm 127 said that, you know, when everything is in vain, there is a monster that wants to invite us, that wants to take us captive. And this monster wants us to become slaves again to performance and to self-effort. And so it says, what's the use? What is the use really? If we now go back out of the freedom that Christ has given us, and he has set us free through the cross of Jesus Christ, he has broken the power of sin and death, and he wants us to stay close to him. But when we trust our self-effort, when we want to go back again and think, might be I've got the answer, or might be, you know, this can help or that can help. It says, it is in vain for you to rise up early, to sit up late, to eat the bread of sorrows. For so he gives his beloved sleep. You see, all our self-effort, all the things that this world tells us we have to do, and, you know, it's good to wear a mask. Yes, it's good to sanitize. Yes, it's good to have a distance. But, you know, these are just minor things. The real issue here is that, am I listening to the Father, or am I trying to save my own life? Because when we save your own life, you will lose it. But when you lose your life for Jesus, you will find it. So that's the exciting part. The temptation is in these days to rely upon ourselves. But God, it says here, gives to his beloved sleep or rest. I think that's a very important aspect. We need to understand that God is not the slave driver. God is not there to make us do things that just want to please him. On the contrary, not only does God provide for proper seasons of rest, he also provides for us while we are resting. He affords physical, emotional recovery, spiritual renewal. And in these days, when you are on your own, when you are just trying to stay and recover, in those moments of quietness, God wants to visit you. God wants to encourage you. And he wants to let you know that, yes, he is with you. He's not wanting to put pressure on you. Like the devil wants pressure on us. He wants us to be involved in the rat race again. But God says, no, you are not called to a rat race. You're called to follow me. And the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they are mighty in bringing down strongholds. We are challenged in these days to put on the brakes to the global rat race, where everybody wants to get back to where they'd been. We're not going back to where they'd been. The most exciting thing that starts off the book of Revelation is in chapter 4, verse 1, where the prophet is called, come up here, come up higher. That's what is God's whole purpose in these days. He wants to get our attention. He wants us to look up. In one of the other Psalms, it says that we need to look up, for our salvation is drawing near. There's something happening in the spiritual realm that needs to awaken us, to make us realize it's not like yesterday, like the day before. No, there's something that's different. And that what is different is that God is calling us closer to himself, higher up to him, so that we can hear his heartbeat and that our prayers become more effective. I'm so excited in these days that we as a body of believers need to stay connected with our Heavenly Father, but also with each other. Else, it's all in vain. And this is a time to bear one another's burdens like never before. How I'm encouraged to see how people reaching out to one another, upholding one another, and praying for one another. We're really becoming an army of love and finding practical ways to bless one another. And his perfect love casts out fear. Hallelujah. His perfect love casts out fear. We are praying for each other like never before. And why? So that we can move on to higher ground. We can't stay where we're at. We want to be there where God has our full attention. And so I was so encouraged the other day. You know, sometimes when I do my devotions, I get out the old hymn book. And then I'm just looking at the old hymns. And I'm amazed how you all of a sudden remember. And you can sing the old hymns. And they speak to you so deeply. And so this one hymn, it's just amazing, where God calls us onto higher ground. Let me just repeat a few verses there. And this, I think, is so important. I'm pressing on the higher ground. New heights I'm gaining every day. Still praying as I'm onward bound. Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. My heart has no desire to stay where doubts arise and fears dismay. Though some may dwell where these abound, my prayer, my aim is higher ground. I want to scale the upward height and catch a gleam of glory bright. But still, I'm praying till heaven I've found. Lord, lead me on to higher ground. And with that, I want to close. Let us just pray together. Father, we thank you. We know that this is not our home. Our home is with you. You have provided for us. You're opening our eyes that things will not be in vain but that we will put our trust back in you and become Christ-like and childlike again, knowing that you want to be our provider. You don't want to take away from us. You want to give freely to us as we first seek your kingdom. And Lord, every heart that's discouraged this morning, I thank you that you will lift them to that higher ground where sin and fear no longer will molest. We praise you for that. Thank you, Father, for every prayer that you are answering in these days. Thank you for all the different churches that are praying together, Lord. We are so excited that we can stand together, shoulder to shoulder, and we will see the victory of our God. In Jesus' name, amen.
We also just, as we end off, we'd like to just pray for Namibia as well. And I'd like to call Gideon and Volker up as well, so we just pray together. And I want to suggest to everyone watching right there where you are in your living room, in your bedroom, wherever, just gather everyone around and let's just pray together. And as you're sitting there, declare the name of Jesus with us this morning. Oh, thank you, Father, that we can come this morning, and Lord, and we wanna bring Namibia before you, Lord. We wanna bring Namibia before you, Lord, and we wanna ask, Lord, that your mercy and your grace will shower over Namibia, Lord, and in this time of COVID, Lord, and with all the anxiousness and everything going around, Lord, we pray that the name of Jesus will rise as a banner over this country, Lord. Over Windhoek, Lord, over every other town that's suffering, Lord, over every hospital, Lord, that's at its fullest capacity and struggling to keep ahead, Lord, we raise a banner, Lord, and on that banner is the name of Jesus this morning. And we declare the name of Jesus. We declare the blood of Jesus over families watching this morning, Lord, right where they are, Lord. We pray that you will touch them, Lord, in that way which only you can do it. Thank you, Jesus, that you died on the cross for us. And by your blood, Lord, we are healed, Lord. We pray for divine healing to set in into families and individuals this morning who are struggling with the symptoms of COVID, Lord. And we stand against it. We stand against the works of the enemy, God. And thank you that we can serve you, God. As a nation, as Namibia, Lord, we also want to repent of sin and we want to turn away from it, Lord. We want to turn towards you, Lord. We want to turn and walk towards you. We want to look up to the heavens, God. We want to move onto that higher ground this morning, Lord. And we just pray for this nation of Namibia, Lord.
Yes, Lord, this is so exciting to proclaim your name because there's no other name by which we can be saved. We praise you that in the name of Jesus, we can proclaim that those who put their trust in you, they shall not be ashamed. Thank you, Father, that you lift every heart, you lift every discouragement from them. And Lord, we praise you for our families, that we can know that you want our families to prosper. We can pray for one another and not grow weary in well-doing, Lord. We lift up your name and say thank you that we can look to you, the author and finisher of our faith. We rejoice, Father, that we can pray for those in authority, that you will protect them from the evil one. You will protect them from those false ideas and false news and things, Lord, that they will not think that they can be the answer to the problem. But Lord, we look to you for the answer and we pray for grace for them, that they will receive it, Father, in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord, this morning we come before you and we glorify your holy name, Heavenly Father. We thank you for your Son, Jesus, that came, that died for us, but was also raised from the dead, Father, so that we might live. And Lord Jesus, we thank you this morning that you came and that you went up to the Father to prepare a place for each and every one of us. And Lord, Father God, without you, we are nothing. So we look unto you this morning, Father, we come to you, we come before you, Father. It might be in our weakness, Father. It might be from a place of discouragement, but we look unto you this morning, Jesus, Father, and we have hope and we find our strength in you this morning. We thank you, Holy Spirit, for your presence. We thank you for your presence in our lives, Lord. We thank you for your guidance. And Father, we thank you, Father, for the hope and the glory that is found in you. We honor you, we worship you as our God and our King. Amen.
You know, I remember a few days ago, you didn't feel so good. You had something with low blood pressure. What happened?
Yeah, thank you, Volker. It's probably one of the effects of the virus. So thought I was recovered, but then I really battled with low blood pressure. And Annika, my wife, she read from Psalm 8, and there, I think it's verse 2 or 3, it actually states the power of prayer, but especially from children as well. And so she asked my children just to lay hands on me, and they prayed, simple prayer of faith, and Jesus healed me. Since then, I must say, I haven't really had any problems, and until now, I'm still standing strong. Once or twice, it wanted to come up and come back again, but in Jesus' name, we speak life, and we rebuke it, and we hold on to the healing that He's provided. All the glory to Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, and I'd like to just encourage you in these days to strain your ears, to keep them open for those good words coming out, those words of testimony that comes out, and to rejoice in it. And and remember that Jesus, those words of Jesus, it is finished. You know, the debt was paid, the sentence served, victory was given. And then Jesus rose from the dead and He gave us that victory. So proclaim it over you and your family, and have a wonderful day. All right.